As COVID rages on this winter, the Miami City Ballet continues to dance, preparing to perform Swan Lake in February under the careful eye of celebrated choreographer Alexei Ratmansky. Jeffrey Brown spent a day with Ratmansky and dancers to see how they have brought this traditional ballet going back to its rediscovered historical roots. It's part of our arts and culture series, Canvas.
Now, almost good, except that you were like too active with your feet going back.
A dance studio several weeks before opening the classic ballet, Swan Lake.
You make it clear for the audience that that's how the love is born.
And Alexei Ratmansky, one of the world's leading choreographers, was working with dancers of the Miami City Ballet to bring to life this fairy tale of a prince, young women turned into swans, and doomed love.
We should get the feeling that the movements are born from the music, or vice versa. The music is born from their movements.
But they go together.
Yes, exactly. Flame in your heart starts growing.
Ratmansky, now 53, was himself a dancer, trained at Moscow's Bolshoi Ballet School, before turning to making dances. Choreography for him begins with the music.
I put on my headphones and I have this little TV in my head.
In your head?
And I see the little figures of dancers doing steps. And then I need to find a good combinations of steps. Remember them, develop them, explain what I mean, explain well to the dancers, inspire the dancers.
But with Swan Lake, he's done something different, returning to the origins of one of ballet's best-known and most loved works. Composed by Tchaikovsky, Swan Lake was given classic shape in 1895 by choreographers Marius Petipa and Lev Ivanov in a production at St. Petersburg's Mariinsky Theater. And then it took wing. It's been reworked and restaged for more than a century, with subtle and large changes to both story and choreography. It got the over-the-top treatment in the 2010 film Black Swan.
What happened to my sweet girl? She's gone!
Ratmansky, a student of dance history, wanted to explore it anew and found early notations in an archive now at Harvard University.
It's a quality of this ballet, which is a masterpiece. You always want to learn from the masters.
Was there a moment where you were surprised and kind of shocked yourself?
Absolutely, yeah. I finally saw the logic in everything.
His new old version, first put on by the Zurich Ballet, strips down some of the action and emphasizes the pantomime and acting. So much about ballet is different now, he says. Dancers' bodies, training, even their toe shoes. So he calls this a historically informed production.
We try to use all the historical materials available, but when we get into the studio, we need to make it live theater.
And that, in an exclusive North American premiere, is now in the works in the Art Deco Miami Beach home of the Miami City Ballet, a company that's taken on both old and new ballets and been acclaimed for its artistry and energy. The company houses a school for the very young, up to dancers like these, age 16 to 18, working under Spanish-born Arancha Ochoa to prepare for auditions with ballet companies far and wide. Training and technique, but also, she says, mental preparation.
We not only care for the training, that's, you know, how do they do that perfect fifth, or how that leg is up there, you know, pointed toes, all of that, but also that they're in the right place, because that's not, you know, once that you get in the company, a lot of them, they get to the company, but then they have to survive in the company.
Artistic director Lourdes Lopez knows the ballet life well. Born in Cuba and raised in Miami, she became a principal dancer with the New York City Ballet. A painting in her office shows her with its legendary leader, George Balanchine. She returned home 10 years ago to take the helm here.
And somehow it felt organic. The art form has given me so much as an immigrant. It has changed my life, and it continues to change my life every day. I mean, I'm sitting in front of you today because of ballet.
A ballet company, she says, feeds and feeds off its city. And this one is very much Miami in its energy and style.
I think American dancers have a sense of urgency, at least certainly Miami City Ballet dancers have a sense of urgency when they're on stage. There's a youthfulness, there's a hunger that they're just gonna eat space and they're gonna just go for it.
There's also an energy and pride here in the diversity of talent. Latina leadership, dancers from all over, especially Central and South America.
For me, it was to come to Miami City Ballet changed my life.
Katia Carranza came to Miami from Mexico at age 19. She'd had plenty of classical training, but found a new world of dancing here.
What was the biggest difference?
For me, it was like everything, it was much faster than what I move. And here I realized there is a lot of ways to move your body. Mm-hmm. And it was a little bit more exciting and more energy and you know, different for me.
Natalia Arja came from Brazil at 15. Now she and Katia are company veterans, getting the extraordinary experience of working with Alexei Ratmansky to create his vision of Swan Lake, especially honing their mime movements to convey the emotions he wants.
We'll spend hours just having a conversation of how do you say you promise to love me? So we'll be—
Without the words.
Without the words, just body language. And Swan Lake Noir is also, it's difficult technically, but most, there's an extra layer of how to, you know, being clear on how you tell the story.
Can you say that to me right now? You promise to love me?
It would be, you, to me, promise to love. But there are so many ways to do that.
Of course, the real black swan in the studio, COVID. This production has already been postponed due to the pandemic, and several weeks out, Lourdes Lopez knew it could happen again.
It's like the bird just doesn't want to land here.
But you're going to bring her down.
I'm going to bring her or him down, whatever it wants to be.
For now, the hard work and the giant leaps go on. For the PBS NewsHour, I'm Jeffrey Brown at the Miami City Ballet.